During this time of year, the weather often cannot seem to decide if it wants to be hot, cold, or in between. The temperature, especially here in Nebraska, can be jarring. It often dances back and forth between being pleasantly warm with a light breeze to bitterly cold, gusty gales. This can make it hard to properly keep your home at a constant, comfortable temperature that is right for you. Luckily, in most homes, a switch of heat or air conditioning is just a push of a button away. However, life was not so simple in the early days of Nebraska. In the settlements of the Pawnee tribes, large, oval-shaped mounds known as earth lodges were home to between 30 and 50 individuals. As tribes often consisted of up to 300 to 500 people, a village might have up to 10 to 20 earth lodges. The lodge was constructed as a hollow dome with a frame of spaced out poles to hold up the structure. A hole was then left in the center top point of the dome and let in light and expelled smoke from the fire pit below. Blankets and mats covered the inside of the walls for insulation in the winter, and the lodge was also dug 3 feet below ground, which helped keep cold air from ventilating into the structure. When the pioneers made their own settlements in Nebraska in the mid-1800s, wooden and sod homes were not easily insulated and often required being heated by stove. Early each winter morning, a large cast iron stove typically situated in the kitchen for cooking would be loaded with wood and lit. Depending on the size of your home, it could easily keep the entire structure perfectly cozy all day. However, when the sun went down and the coals burned deep in the stove, the home grew chilly once more. When summer brought warm temperatures, life changed drastically. The stove still had to be used, so the home and its inhabitants needed a way to keep cool during hot days. Doors of the home needed to be opened for ventilation. However, opening doors had a tendency to let in local wildlife. Screen doors were an excellent addition to homes and kept the critters outside while still allowing air to flow through. As time and ingenuity progressed, technology would make advancements in how homes were heated and cooled more easily. By the 1900s, electricity made it possible to bring small portable units into your home and into individual rooms. This electric heater was made by Nelson Machine and Manufacturing Company in 1920. The unit used electrically heated coils and a copper reflector dish to radiate heat. This made it possible to heat a small area of the home, such as a bedroom or bathroom. These units, however, were not without flaws. The heating element did not have a regulated temperature or protective screen to keep people from burning themselves. They also required being placed in an area that was not near any fabric or flammable materials, as early heating elements were notorious for catching homes on fire. Cooling fans, like this one made by General Electric in 1901, had a different problem to keep in mind. As they also had no protective screen, it was easy to reach the fan blades and injure fingers, especially for children. Even still, these items helped make life easier for individuals in an unpredictable and ever-changing environment.